Now we are going to talk about a very nice feature about OBAL board. This is the disarm switch or the safety switch. This is not the safety switch like the one in PixHAwk, because the one in PixHAwk is controlled by the Ardupilot, which means that Ardupilot checks the status of this switch, and accordingly it controls whether or not to send data to the PWM output to spin the motors. But in this case, this is an external switch. This switch uses a pin here, which is servo enable, pin number 11. If this pin is low, then and the header here is connected, then the voltage here is zero, and BCA here is zero, and this chip is enabled, and the PWM can be output from this chip. I mean, if this is a chip uses I2C and is controlled by Ardupilot software here that runs on Raspberry, so it will, if Ardupilot wants to output signal to motors, it will send the necessary I2C commands to this chip. And if this pin is zero, then this chip will be able to output actual signals to speed controllers and to motors and to servos as well. But if this value is 5 volt, then here it is 5 volt, and this output is high, and this chip is disabled, so there is no output to the motors, even if Ardupilot software is sending commands to this chip and ordering the motors to run. It will not run because this pin prevented from output PWM signals to motors. So there is two ways to control this value. The first thing is to control servo enable, and servo enable is controlled from the Ardupilot code itself. The other thing is that this switch, if you disconnect these pins, then this, regardless of this value, the voltage here is 5 volt, and that means the chip is disabled. So regardless of what Ardupilot software wants, if you disconnect this switch, the motors will not spin, and Ardupilot will assume that it is spinning, but it will not spin. And this is useful because if you want to test your circuit and your board safely without, and everything is connected, you don't need to disconnect anything, you just need to turn off this switch, and this can be an on-off switch. You need to turn off this switch, and in that case the motors will not spin. Also, the mission planner and everything will show that the board is armed and everything is work, but in reality the motors will not run. Another case, sometimes if you hit aggressively your quadcopter and the connections were not reliable for any reason, so Raspberry Pi could restart, and in that case, if this board was sending PWM signals to the motor, it will not stop. It will keep sending the same signal until it receives new commands from Raspberry. But since Raspberry is restarting, it will not send new command. So that means the motors are running without control. But in this case, if this switch is on, which is logical because the motors were running, so this switch is on. So when Raspberry restarts, this signal goes to high automatically, and in this case the voltage here is 5 volt, and the motors will stop. So this is a safety mechanism to prevent motors to run when Raspberry restart, or if you want to force the motors not to start you can switch this switch off and it will never start regardless of status of Ardupilot or the board. It will never start.